Good morning. Good morning. It's Israel Wendy. Today I'm going to be doing some painting, and also I'm going to be talking about missions. And it kind of looks like I'm out of sync here. Good morning. Good morning. Thank you for joining. Thank you for the hearts. Even if it was unintentional. God bless you this morning, and we're gonna get some worship music going, and make sure that you share to your followers so they can watch the painting going on and hear some worship music. So God bless you, and we'll get started here. We have a clean slate this morning. It's nice and white. And it's a little bit bigger painting than what I usually do. Maybe I should back it up, but I'm not going to. We'll keep it this close. Anyway, to tomorrow, if you join me tomorrow at around 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, I will be doing gospel music, but today we're just going to do some random worship music. And we'll get started here. And hopefully everything works okay today. Here it comes. Now I've taken some titanium white acrylic paint. Good morning, good morning. And I've mixed some gloss into it so it'll be shiny. And added a little bit of water. And I am just gonna paint a nice wet coat here. We want it wet. And I'm not going to paint the whole thing, just the top part. And we're going to try some a different technique today. We're going to be mixing some paint right on the canvas. This is called the wet paint method. And again, it's just some titanium white with a little bit of gloss in it. And I'm keeping it real wet. And trying to have a nice, even, thin coat here. So each time I take the brush off the canvas, I'm dunking it in my water here. Make it real wet. Breathe the breath of God
Breathe, oh breath of God, now breathe. Breathe, oh breath of God. Oh breath of God. Oh breath of God, oh breathe.
Thank you for the hearts. Welcome, welcome. Welcome this morning, Steve. I'm glad you could join. Just make sure this is nice and even and there's no excess paint on here, but it needs to be a little bit wet. Okay.
Come alive. About all the ashes, let us sing a morning.
Now I'm going to take some cobalt blue. It's kind of a medium blue, and this is acrylic paint. And then again, I'm going to add a little gloss to it so that it's nice and shiny. And I'm going to start at the top and I'm just going to mix in with the white a little bit. So we're mixing paint in little circles here. I'm going to take a dry brush and just kind of put some of the, hey, good morning, Jason. I'm going to put some of the blue into the white, and because it's wet, it should mix nice. Make it look kind of wispy like clouds. So now we got some haziness to our painting. It's kind of like the weather this morning. It was really foggy and hazy, and it was really hard to drive through. Then you got these people that don't use their headlights, and that's not good. All right, so that's our hazy sky. I'm going to get a little bit of God bless you, Jason. I was just going to talk about missions, but you can catch the replay. And I'm going to use some medium blue here. And we're gonna paint down below here. It's gonna be some water. And I got it a little bit too wet, but that's okay. Well, actually, it's a little bit too wet, but it's makes a nice effect. So, hey. We got to get some music going here. Yeah. This is just, it says primary blue. It's kind of a medium blue. Welcome to the broadcast. I'm trying some new techniques today. I've been watching that Bob Ross. I guess he's controversy, I don't know. But anyway. Well, this is some water here. Yeah, his hair is controversial.
is enough for me.
There's a few areas in here where I didn't get enough color on there. There we go.
No turning back, no turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back,
no turning back. I'm gonna add some waves in there. I'm gonna just put a little bit of white waves in here. Wow, we got some thunder going on outside. I don't know if you can hear it, but wow. I always get painting and then somebody calls me. Why is it that that happens? I'm gonna put a little more white in here. A little more white in here. I want just a little bit more light in our painting here because, you know, it looks a little dingy. It looks like a storm coming. I want to have some light in our clouds here.
Thank you.
There, that adds a little more lightness to the painting. There, a little more white in her. I'm using a silver paint, metallic paint to do the boat. Put a boat right in here. Welcome, Marcy. That was an awesome fire scope this morning. Throw up some emojis. If people aren't following you, they need to follow Marcy because she has some very informative scopes. And she's part of the Jesus Did It group. It's a group of broadcasters that are bringing the gospel and the love of Christ to the rest of the world. Now it's so foggy in our painting here that there's only going to be a kind of a hint of the boat. It's going to kind of disappear into the fog. And that was Jay Thomas, and this is Chris Tomlin. I'm sorry I didn't see your comment. It's hard to watch the comments and paint. I don't know if I'm going to do an ocean liner or if I'm going to do like a sailboat. I like the silver paint. It's kind of thin now. Yeah, you have a blessed day too. God bless you. I'm gonna make this like a bigger boat, not a sailboat. I'm just letting it dry so I can put a little more silver on there. Trying to find a picture of an ocean liner here. So it was. This is an old one, but I always like this song. Let's try a tugboat. Ocean liner looks not what I was imagining.
There should I.
Okay, I got too many windows open here.
Everything's your glory. Who's calling your strength?
Morning, Jerry. Sorry I didn't see you come in, but thank you for the hearts. Welcome, welcome to the broadcast. You'll have to catch the replay to see the rest of the painting. Welcome. How are you, Michelle? Making a little boat here, like a tugboat. I looked at ocean liners, but they looked a little bit too complicated, so. And I got a bald spot on my boat, but I can't seem to get the paint to stick to it. I don't know why. Maybe it's not meant to be. Put it on thick, let it dry a minute and see what happens. I don't know what to do. That's like a bald spot right there. I just don't know. It doesn't want to cover. And while the music has stopped, I just wanted to read a little bit on missions. Many of you are part of the Jesus Did It group, and we're trying to raise money for Jason to go to the Dominican. And we had a fundraiser and raised some money. And just in the spirit of missions, I thought I would read from my mission journal that, and this was from 2013. When I went to the Dominican myself. That Sunday, we got there Saturday, and so Sunday I wrote in my journal that we had lunch, then it was on those horrible trucks, those horrible cattle trucks. We went to Village 50, a project that MGM, or Meeting God in Missions, was working on. This village was the worst that I have ever seen. There were dirt floors and rubble that they used as homes, with just a tin roof overhead. The children were dirty, the people had that blank stare and hardened features that I have come to know as hopelessness. The children were very bold in begging, asking for money, and it broke my heart when they asked me for water and I couldn't give them water because the leaders of the mission told us not to share our water bottles. Jesus says that if you refuse water to the least of his children, he will refuse water to you, and that just broke my heart. I cried right on the spot. MGM is building a beautiful village for these beautiful people. It is concrete with concrete floors. A man that has lived 75 years in this village says he has never seen concrete floors before. The sun here is very hot. Even this is the cool season in the middle of winter time. Concrete helps keep the homes cool and keeps the bugs out. I have not seen too many bugs here, although I see many of the construction crew bit up by sand fleas. These villages are in the fields of sugarcane. And I have been told that there are huge centipedes and tarantulas there. I did not see any schools near the village, and I pray that MGM crew is building a school there. They are hoping to have the village completed and people moving in by the end of the week. If I can turn the page here. I wrote down a lot of devotions here, so I'm just trying to find the parts where I talked about. Anyway, part of my devotions the next day, I wrote, how much more important is it to spend time with our God, the one whom we are attached to like a branch? If that branch falls off, will it not wither and die? But yet we take our responsibility and relationship to God for granted. If you knew that your child was going to shortly die, wouldn't you spend all the time you could with that child? We know not the hour of our death. Why do we not strive to bring God's word to those who have not heard it? we may not have another chance. We may not have a chance to accept the Lord as our Savior either. Yesterday, we had several people that refused to accept Jesus. They would say, oh, I can do that tomorrow. Or what if tomorrow never comes? They had excuses. Some of the excuses were that they were afraid that they would lose their livelihood because many of them prostitute themselves out. I went into Hasta Mañana again on the prayer walk. We had three saved, including a very emotional save, a 16-year-old. I had four little girls hanging on me, and I showed them how to pray and lay hands on people while they were praying. I prayed for their protection. I showed them how to use hand sanitizer, and one accidentally put it in her eyes and was crying. The village had a few nice homes, but most were dirty, with little tin roofs, very little yard, and it was so very, very dirty. I showed them how to wash their hands with hand sanitizer, and they had so much fun with that. I was touched by this Creole woman who had two little babies, only like 10 months apart. We asked if she would like to accept Jesus. We prayed for her. I'm going with an interpreter, Arlene, who is a full-time missionary, and Kay, a sweet little lady. Our interpreter is named Bellamy. He is truly amazing in that he is fluent in three languages, maybe more. I learned that a dove symbol on the houses means the Holy Spirit lives here. And it was so joyful for me to see that. We came back. This is the next day. We came back and I practiced with the worship team. It was amazing. They gave me headship and I introduced two new songs. And we had them ready for the next day's worship just that fast. We even recruited a baritone voice. These guys, the Dominican guys, are truly dedicated to worship, music, and listening to and playing nothing but. Even their Moringa type music is Christian. They go to church every day, sometimes twice a day. Several of the members of our team had to fly back home because they became very sick. Before they left, everyone prayed over them for their healing and gave them encouragement. The next day, we went to a very bad village to bring free medical and free eyeglasses. I had never seen such depravity. Writing this now, I just want to cry. They had concrete houses, unlike the Village 50, but they were filthy. Children ran naked, were not attended to, and we even saw someone playing with a knife. They had entire families living in an area about the size of my bathroom. Many have asked for prayer for safety because they are afraid that what they have will be stolen. I met a lady named Rosa. She was beautiful. She was dressed unlike the rest. She said she was a Christian and needed prayer for her safety because she was alone. And being that she was Haitian and she was afraid of the Dominicans. She was from Haiti, couldn't get back. Many are illegals in the country looking for work. They come and they cannot get back because they are afraid of consequences when they do. We met a lady whose husband had died, leaving her with nothing and 10 children to feed. She was with a cousin and a sister, but they couldn't help because they were just as poor. She said through the interpreter that her church wasn't able to help either, and she was very mad and wanted to find a new church. There were three in this village. We prayed for her. I have been baptized in fire down here. The needs are so overwhelming. Everyone wants a Bible, but we only have a few, and they are in Spanish. Many speak Creole, which is like French. The Haitians look a little different than the Dominicans. They are lighter skinned. Some almost look white. While the Dominicans are very dark, the Haitians have a round, long face, and the Dominicans are rounder. And they seem to fight among each other. This is on the fourth day. We went again to the bad village. I can't remember its name, or maybe I never heard it. Just a village that workers of the sugarcane fields made. They don't even have a name. They have numbers like Village 50. The landowners let them live there free to work the sugarcane. But conditions are terrible, and it smells like sewage. This is the winter season, because I went in January. This is the winter season for them, and it sometimes is 90 degrees. I can't imagine what it would be like in the summertime. Today we met one of the daughters of the woman who said that she had lost her husband and had 10 children to raise. She said she had a demon or something in her head. And Rosa, who we had met earlier yesterday, said she was crazy. Rosa, the Haitian, speaks English very well, so she followed us around. But through questioning, I believe that this child, who was 16, was depressed because her father had just died 2 months ago. The villagers don't understand depression, though they say the person is crazy. I prayed for her through Bellamy to have strength and turn to Jesus for comfort. We prayed to cast out any demons that we came across. Then we came across a man that was only a skeleton. He had been too sick and was too weak to go to our free clinic. So one of our team went and fetched the doctor. He was only 60, but he looked so old. We all slipped him food because he said that he hadn't been eating because he has no one to care for him. And if you don't work, you don't eat. The men prayed for him, and he said he was a Christian. He is not too long for this world, but soon will be in paradise, we told him. The houses were concrete, not much bigger than my bathroom. They washed out front of their houses, the same place they cooked, and children played. We saw little kids playing with machetes. We saw a man come in from the fields. He was so skinny with torn clothes. He had a huge machete and a wide hoe. In this village, if you can't work, you don't eat. He wasn't a Christian and wouldn't accept, so we prayed over him anyway for strength. We prayed over who would want prayer and prayed for others to accept Christ. We led 5 people that day. Then it was in the cattle trucks again for the 45-minute ride back to the mission. We went to the cowboy church. We prayed that the Dominican Republic becomes like the United States. That's what they wanted us to pray for. They want respect like other people. I can't read what that says. Somebody grew up mentally different, not in the church. Saul grew up mentally different, not in the church. Saul later persecuted Christians. Saul saw that he was sinning, but before, what he was doing wasn't sin to him, but he didn't know. He didn't know he was doing bad sins. He knew one of the first men that died because they were a Christian. The people that were in the way at the time were Christians. A little time later, that they knew that Christians followed. Jesus, there are many people who sin, but they don't know. They don't know God's plan in their life. If a person doesn't choose to follow Jesus, is it the same as what happened to Saul? There are many people in this place, in the Dominican, that need to find Jesus. Maybe they are Christians, but they need a meeting with Jesus. Put your plans in the Lord's plans. There are many times you wonder what is happening to us, but they do not have time to spend with the Lord. Our lives can be a good way. When he comes to spend time with Jesus, we need to fall down and surrender. It is important to God to surrender. We can have a good life in him. There are many people in here that need to check themselves, check their lives, check their plans in him. Are wholesome. Realize that the Lord may be a little bit away from you. The cowboy church was awesome. They spoke in tongues and worshiped God to no abandon. They danced in circles around the small church. I saw a little Dominican baby with blonde hair. I learned later that this is what happens from starvation. His mother was deathly thin, but was so happy in the Lord. There was only a few of us Americans that went, but Brian and I went up front to lead worship. We sang 2 songs that I knew, but we sang them in Spanish. God has given me an unbelievable ability to read lips and sing in Spanish. I don't know what I was singing, but the Holy Spirit was strong there. We rode back in the cattle truck. I got to ride in the front. Old ladies do that. The roads were extremely bad until we got back into Hato Mayor. That is a major city where the people all over. There was no road rules, even though there are posted signs. The bigger the vehicle, the more right to the road they have. Often our bus and cattle truck vehicles rode side by side on a double line. Motorcycles were everywhere. If you stop at a red light, you get harassed and made to go. there are vehicles parked in the middle of the road, motorcycles driving at night without lights, motorcycles with four and five people on it, even vehicles driving backwards down the street. I should start an x-ray clinic down there. I would have a lot of business. Everywhere we went, we yelled, "Hola!" And when you said gracias, they always said de nada, which meant you're welcome. Although the children at the front gate could be rude in their begging. I went back to the compound. I am going back in June, God permitting. I know that it will be a very hard and hot and humid, but there are so many unfinished works of God there. It is amazing just what God has done through me. He has done miracles like Thursday night, talent night, when I was able to sing a worship song in Spanish above all by reading the keyboard player's lips. He has an awesome voice, and I can play guitar and keyboard, God taught. I would sing a song, and he and I were performing the song within 5 to 10 minutes. Joel was another guitar player I worked with. He and Arturo have released an album of Christian rap. He put some on my iPod to take back with me. They were so shocked to learn that I wasn't the worship team leader back at home, because I was so motivated and introduced 3 new songs just in the week I was there. Of course, all that I have been through in my life had been leading up to that and orchestrated by God. When the Holy Spirit came upon me, I could make the missionaries cry and convict the masses, but only God in me. For without Him, I was nothing. They wanted me to come a whole month next year. Arlene in our prayer group was so happy to mentor me, and I to learn how to have souls through leading others to Christ. I truly am changed. No longer will I be a fan of Christ. I will be a follower. I have been truly blessed, and I hope that I have been a blessing to all that I have hugged, held, prayed for, prayed with, laughed with, and cried with, and simply loved like Christ would. It was sad that so many got sick, and that several had to leave and go home early. But I felt blessed. Not a single stomach ache or until I was near the voodoo stuff. Twice I felt the evilness in my gut. Twice I prayed for protection and to cast out any evil spirits, and it went away immediately. God and Jesus are so much more powerful than that voodoo stuff. I wish I could tell them how voodoo just opens the door for evil to enter. We were instructed not to mention it all, but we all felt bad when we saw little babies with voodoo bands on to protect them. That is mostly a Haitian influence, but it is spreading. but not as quickly as Christianity is. Most all of the people we met have heard the story of Jesus. They beg us for Bibles. It is sad we don't have more to give out, but they're very scarce in this area. When you walk with God, the impossibility or the impossible becomes logical. Village 50 has been there 70 or more years. The villagers feel like we are building for a king. We are. We're building for Jesus. Christianity is a relationship. He wants to spend time with you. The judgment seat, when we are face to face with God, where is our realization that we will face him? Are we faithful on earth? This experience terrified Paul, and he strove to live the best life of obedience. God doesn't force his will on us. We will be called upon to give an account for our actions. Accountability is good for us. Each person is judged according to their works. When unsaved people die, they die on earth. They die again in the lake of fire. It is so sad. When you live by faith, your life shows it. After breakfast, we loaded up in the cattle trucks and the bus. We were all headed to Village 50 to hand out bags of clothes. We had enough for each family to have one and bags of shoes also. They also decided to pick up garbage. This was the last day before we left, because another missionary team was building an incinerator to burn their garbage, and yet another team was coming to build latrines because they just potty everywhere. In fact, some of what I was picking up was just that, with gloves, of course. A lady just handed me her toddler and little boy over to me. The three of us, me with a baby on my hip and a boy toddling around, we picked up garbage. And the mother was serious. She truly wanted me to take her children. But they ran back to mom after a while. Children run wild and get tangled up in a thorn bush of some type and get thorns, and I got some in my skin. They looked red and swollen, but I prayed over them, and God healed them, so that all is left is the dots of where there was thorns. When I was picking up this garbage and teaching the children to do the same, someone was videotaping me, so I don't know if he thought I was a native or if he was doing it for the Meeting God in Missions crew. It ought to be interesting. Bellamy, our interpreter, held on to me almost in tears. He kept saying that he was going to miss me. I felt he was getting ready to kiss me, so I tactfully said that he reminded me of my son, who was about the same age. Bellamy said he was 32. Then when I told him I was 49, he kept saying, "No, no, no, you have such a baby face." He thought I was like 30. I said that it was the Holy Spirit and that I'm a new creation in Christ. We all are. God loves us so much and has taken such good care of me that I have no worry lines on my face. I hope I didn't break his heart. But others on the worship team thought I was young, too. And the last day, I'm looking at my devotions here. We did devotions every day. That Saturday, it is extremely hard for me to say goodbye to all that I met there. I kind of avoided all and stayed to myself as I was packing, but at the last hour decided to get people's addresses, etc. I had a lot of prayers for Carmen, who caused my friend Effie to cry in the dorm. I found out that she was a pastor, and I will continue to pray for her and her congregation. I boarded the plane with much regret. I wanted to stay because there was so much work that needed to be done. We did not finish Village 50. The plane ride was extremely nerve-wracking for me, especially because I had prayed that there would be somebody beside me on the plane that would hold my hand as I went home. But that had taken, I can't even read my own writing because there's tear marks everywhere. That had taken the fear away on the way down, and prayer had given me strength. I had only rude people to sit next to me on the way back, but God was so gracious to me that I got home safely. I had given all my clothes away except for my dirty long pants and shorts and a t-shirt and water shoes. I froze all the way back. God told me this would happen when we were coming to the DR on the plane, so I was prepared. Although I prayed that everyone would get better from their illnesses all that last night, and I feel that God is just with us every step of the way. I got back at 3 a.m. to my house after my son had picked my freezing sorry self up from the airport, and I dropped him off at home. I went from 90 degree weather to 1 degree weather. At home, I almost immediately became sick from the doggy smell and had to clean up before I went to bed. My doggy smell. I crawled into bed and said, God, if you want me to go to church, you will have to wake me up, which he did. I threw on a pair of jeans, the hanky on my head, and a warm shirt and headed off. I had written on a piece of paper a few things I wanted to say to the congregation. Number one, braids. Number two, routine. Number three, prayer walk. Number four, cry. I told the pastor that I had a few words to say, four words. First, I told them about my braids and how the children were supporting their families with that. The few dollars that I paid to have my hair braided. I explained the compound and how the kids hung around at the gate each day and how Brian had sat outside to get his hair braided and how he took it out every night so that he could bless the children by having them braided again the next day. I explained our routine and how important daily devotions were. I asked how often we open our Bibles and how the Dominicans were begging for Bibles. Then I explained the prayer walk and told several stories of the villagers. I concluded with how full of God these people were. They have nothing, yet they have more than we do. Our possessions weigh us down. I explained how we need to confess our sins because it is sin that separates us from God. I sang one of the songs that we sang every day at the compound, and I asked if the congregation truly loves Jesus and how we are showing that love. Jesus's love, nothing more than when we spend time with him. Then I told them how one of the construction workers told me that at Village 50, the people ask, "Are you building a palace for a king?" And I asked, as I pointed to myself, "Are you building a palace for a king?" I didn't have a single dry eye in the congregation, and I took over half an hour of the pastor's sermon. Unfortunately, because it was Super Bowl Sunday, not everyone was there, and my sermon was not recorded. But God knows how the Holy Spirit worked in me and how I tried to reach out to our church. I hope to truly get our church to move in the Holy Spirit and not to stifle it. I will continue to give God my daily devotion and to grow closer to him. And that was just my first mission tour. Since then, I've actually moved to a different church, a church that is not quite as dry. But anyway, I can't get the paint to stick in that one spot. Isn't that horrible? So, God bless you. I will see you guys tomorrow. Jesus loves you. Check out the JesusDidIt.org website.